Hello everybody. I would like to share with you in this video some important tactics and approaches that can significantly improve the outcome of your medical education or your educational lectures in the field of medicine. First of all, I would like to briefly introduce myself. My name is Tarek Abdelhamid, and I'm a medical doctor, educationalist, founder of MedLearn, which is a medical educational channel with more than 100,000 doctors subscribing to it and millions of views. I'm also the developer or creator of the multidimensional learning model, which was the very first successful step to integrate cognitive psychology and memory studies in the field of medical education effectively. I created this model in 1996, but I applied it in different areas in medical education. I would like initially to share with you some of the images of my videos that appealed to many doctors all over the world. Particularly, initially, I started with the Arabic-speaking doctors, mixing some English and Arabic in the lecture. But in the next stage, I am taking MedLearn to another level, which is making it in pure English for English-speaking audience as well. Let me just start by saying that when I create a video, and the videos are, as you can see, very successful with huge number of audience and followers. When I create a video, I go into the following steps, typically 6 steps to create any educational video in the field of medicine. And this can certainly benefit pharmacists, dentists, and any other one who works in the area of health, such as nurses. But initially, I created MedLearn basically for medical doctors. So I'll speak about this area of medical education. And initially, I go into the following step, a selection of the information. Typically, I choose relevant information for their medical practice because doctors are so busy. And when you give him some information that's pure theoretical, many of them might not have much interest in watching the videos or gaining the information. So it's important to select information that has some practical application in their daily life. That is the first step of creating a lecture in medicine, or a short lecture or video. The second step is educational designing. By the word educational designing, I mean, what type of educational design am I going, or I'm going to choose for this piece of information, or this information I have selected? Am I going to do it as a simple lecture, or choose the one best answer, or fill in the spaces, or matching style questions, or interactive lectures where I give some information and wait for an answer and react to this by adding more information, explaining the point. So it's vital to move across all of them. It's important to give sometimes a simple lecture, sometimes to give quizzes, sometimes to make it interactive or MCQ or fill in the spaces. We need to move here and there to make it really interesting for them to follow. The third step that I use is graphic design. So after I go with the selection of information, as I mentioned, and after this, I go with the educational design, what type of lecture format I'm using. I go to the graphic design in step 3. With graphic design, I mean, what type of illustrations am I going to use? Am I going to use just a man or a woman, an old man, an ECG, X-ray? What type of arrows I'm going to use? Is it going to be red with certain theme for endocrinology, for example, or blue for nephrology, or green with rheumatology? You can here design your graphic design based on certain color codes with certain topic, for example, discipline, medical discipline. After this, I take it to another level, which is step 4 of education, enrich the encoding of the selected information. By this, I mean what to add to the lecture to enrich the encoding of information in our human brain and mind. I can add x-rays, ECGs, an image for a patient, sonography, illustration. All of this can add and enhance the process of education and medical learning in the human brains. The fifth level, or step five, is to add cognitive psychology elements to improve the educational process. And this was part of the multidimensional learning model, which I would like to add a link at the end. You will find it in the box beneath the video. The multidimensional learning model discusses different ways of cognitive psychology elements that can enhance the learning process, such as the spreading activation model, where information can be connected from one discipline to another one to a third one to create a sort of network in the brain of related information. The generation effect, when you ask the student or the doctor to think to generate the answer, that's very powerful way of education. Rehearsal within the critical 30 seconds. It's important after shifting the information to the short-term memory stores to take it further to the long-term memory stores via rehearsal of the information within critical 30 seconds to activate certain calcium channels in the brain and move the information to the long-term memory stores. Contextual variability. You can use the same information in different contexts, sometimes as a story of a patient, sometimes as a question, sometimes as a short just description. Encoding variability, you use different ways of encoding. Sometimes you use certain color code, for example, or another time you connect it to another network in the brain of internal medicine, for example, you relate it to another topic or give a practical application to it. So you enrich the encoding of information. And you can use mnemonics, for example, occasionally here and there, A, B, C, D, E. You put the points as A for whatever, B, C, D. You can use bizarreness. Some images may need to be bizarre or characteristic so that I remember when I see this image. Yeah, I remember this condition, the treatment was this and that. So you can really use different cognitive psychology elements, and you can find many of them in the multidimensional learning model, which I will share with you in the box underneath the video. The sixth step, or step six, is to start your teaching after creating all of these steps. So the process of education is can be simple if we take it as steps. The very first step is to select the information that's relevant to the doctors or pharmacists, dentists, nurses, whoever you teach. And then you take it to step two, the educational designing. Is it a simple lecture or fill in the spaces or matching style questions? And then you take it to the graphic design level where you use certain illustrations or to make it more memorable. And then you enrich the encoding in the brain of the selected information by adding depth, by using x-rays, ECGs, echo, sonography, illustrations. And then you add cognitive psychology elements, such as the spreading activation model, generation effect, contextual and encoding variability to improve the educational outcome. And finally, you can start your lecture. And this is how I create my videos. And I believe this was part of their success and why they appeal to many doctors in the Middle East and all over the world. I have many followers here in America and in Europe, actually globally, but many of them are in the Middle East now because I use Arabic and English in my traditional lectures. And I'm considering adding specific lectures in English to the English speaking audience all over the world. It was a pleasure to talk to you. And I hope these points helped. And you can contact me via my email. I will add it also in the box underneath the video. And welcome to MidLearn. Thank you.